Hey everyone, I'm back again with my third video, and this video I will be showing you Microsoft Teams for Admin Center. This is particularly for admins of Microsoft Teams who will be managing Microsoft Teams in their organization. In the first two videos, that was for beginners and for those who will be using Microsoft Teams desktop and online version. So I would highly suggest to go and watch my first two videos, that is Microsoft Teams Overview 1, Part 1 and Part 2. Okay, so without further delaying any further, let's start our third session, Part 3. And in this part, I'm going to show you Microsoft Teams Admin Center. So how do you go there? So if you have Office 365 account, just log into portal.office.com, click Admin. Once you click Admin, you will be coming here in Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Okay. Go down, you will see a Teams. So this is the Teams Admin Center. And previously it was used to called Skype for Business Admin Center, but that is not anymore. It has been deprecated. So now it is showing as Teams Admin Center. So let's click on Teams Admin Center. I've already clicked it. And we have Microsoft Teams Admin Center here. So this is the first default screen for Microsoft Teams Admin Center. You will see the my status for Teams upgrade. It has already been upgraded from Skype for Business to Teams, and it also has a card for user search where you can search for users right away from the dashboard. And this is activity log. Currently there is no such activity for past 30 days. It's a chart for Teams user activity. I will show this chart later on in the reporting section. And these are some more details and training and help. So this is a simple dashboard, nothing such useful here. So let's go to the second option. We have manage Teams. Okay. So in manage Teams section, you will be seeing your teams that are in your organization. These all teams you can see. I have these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 teams. So these columns are standard channel, private channels, and team members and owner. Standard channels means the one who has only journal channel. Okay, because journal channel is the only one channel which is created by default. This is a standard channel. And if I create any new custom channel, it will be shown as a number 2. Like in the crisis management channel, crisis management team, I have 2 channels. Okay, one is journal and one is another I created. Okay, there's no private channels here. And the team members, how many team members are there in these teams? You can see it here. How many owners? I have only one owner for each team. Okay, so if you see the details of each team, let's click on anyone. You can see it's public team, like, because anyone can join it. This is the email address for this team. So if you want to do email to these team members from Outlook, you can just use this email address. That's it. You can see members here, only 2, myself and Nabil. I'm the owner and Nabil is a member. So I can change myself as a member from right away from here. Okay, I can add other members as well from here. In the channel section, we have the journal channel is standard channel. We have it is created by default, and this channel I created myself. Okay. In the settings, you will see the settings that has been applied on this team, but you cannot change the settings from here. Okay. You can only change your team settings from the teams. Like if I go to any teams here, okay. Click here in manage team, and settings. You will see the settings here. So the settings can be changed from here, but in the Teams Admin Center, you will only see the information of which settings had been applied on the team. Okay. Teams policy. So there are some policies because what Microsoft has done is for administrator, they have to apply policies for the organization to implement the settings, preferences, and applications and messages settings, okay, for your teams. Because if an organization has more than 100 teams or 500 teams, it will be a complete administrative headaches for administrators if they go by default, if they go manually change the settings. So what Microsoft has done is they have created policies, a rule of policies. So by using the policies, we can implement our initiatives and our definitions to mess a number of teams as just in a single step. Okay, so this policy, global organization by default, this is created by default. This is created by Microsoft. So you can change it if you want, like if you select it and click edit, you can change this policy global name, anything, or you can add your own. Okay, so this policy will be used in every other team sections, like in the messaging in the application, to change your preferences. Okay, like if I create new policy, okay, these two are toggles, like discover private teams. So any new private teams will be discovered by this policy, so this policy will be applicable to them. And this create channels, so it means that you will enable your users to create private channels. Okay, so let me create it. So we have now created a demo policy for our teams. You can duplicate it, delete it, or even manage users. In the manage user section, it means to whom it will be applied. Like if I want to only apply to some set of groups or users, so I can write here. Okay. Let's go to the next section, devices. In the devices, it's like how you manage your devices on your organization. Like, because in Teams, it is all about calling and having conferences calls. Okay, so you need devices like phones, like IP phones, conference phones. Okay, projectors, anything. So you can add those here, because right now I have no phones currently here. It's an optional step. You can use it, but it's a good thing to use it. Okay, you can manage all your phones here, your settings, your policies to your devices right from the Teams Admin Center. Okay, similarly, collaboration bar are also the part of collaboration meetings, so you can add your collaboration bars as well. So it's a part of devices. Okay, locations. So what you can do is, from the local reporting, from this section, reporting label is, because in an organization there's only a single network or multiple network, you would say, or a particular network that user come in and connect to it. So here in Teams Admin Center, you can specify a location data where your employees, whenever they connect to your organization network, they will be able to connect to the right subnet and to a right network where they will be able to use Teams. Okay, so right now I have no such specification here. Like, I can write the CSV file of which location and their IP subnet. So this will be reported here, and for with respect to our team members, they will be able to use the Teams accordingly to the network. So it's part of a network design. Okay, if you can see the description here, reporting labels are used to give an IP subnet a name that links to a physical location, like office or buildings. Okay, so if there are two offices, like for our organization, in two cities, so you can specify their locations and their IP subnets. Okay, so the employees of each offices of an organization can then be able to use the Teams accordingly. Okay, emergency addresses, it's part of like what you can say is a setting for your administrators. Just like you can see on your mobile phones, they have a emergency phone number, emergency dial. So this is the same thing. Like if there is some kind of a disaster that happens or anything that happen, So you can specify an emergency number here or emergency location where your user will be able to call or your user will be able to reach there for emergency purposes. Okay, this is only that place. So you can use it for your needs if you have, but it's an optional thing. Network topologies, same like I discussed in the first section. So if you have any network topology applicable in your organization, obviously you would have mostly in organization there is a controlled environment. So there is a controlled network here there, because we have VNets, we have subnets, and we have certain firewalls. So what you can do is you can deploy your network sites here, your network topologies here, and even your trusted IPs, which will be able to use Teams. Okay, because it is related to only Teams, so anything that you will be applying here will be applicable to Teams only. Okay, so for the administrative point of view, if you design your Teams architecture, network plays a very important role. So just design a topology based on your organization network network settings and IP subnets, anything, and then add it here. Okay, so this will tell you like you can write your network site here, the description, any network region if you have, any network location based routing. Okay, like I said, if there are two offices, okay, so one has different routes, a routing table, the other has different routing table, so you can select, turn this on. Okay, emergency calling, these are two policies, the global policies, routing policies, subnets. Okay, each subnet must be associated with a specific network site. Okay, so this will specify a client location or an office location of your Teams where it will be using. Okay, so this is the network topology, networks and location. Next, go to next. Same here, you can add the subnets and manage your subnets here. Okay, don't mix it up with your Azure subnets. Okay, Azure subnets is where you manage and you create your subnets. This is only for like for Teams network design. Okay, so any subnets that you have created either in Azure VPN or in local VPN, so these can be managed or created here. Okay, Wi-Fi access points, switches, ports, all you can manage here. Right, let's go to the next section, users. So like the name says, users, you'll be managing all your users and even your groups here. Okay, and see their policies also. Like if this user Adil Mukhtar, let's see the policies applied for him. So this is a user in our organization. This is his email address. There is no 7 day, this is no call quality data right now because he hasn't used any. So this is the account information. Coexistence mode is only team only, because I'm only using Teams in my organization. There is no Skype for Business. If there would be a Skype for Business, then it would be called island mode, because there are two islands. One is Teams and one is Skype for Business. Okay, because I'm not using Skype for Business in my organization, that so it is only team mode, team only. Voice, any outbound call settings, any here for this particular user, any call history, there is nothing. So these are the policies applied for this particular user only. So right, if you can see, only global organization policy is applied. But if I go here and check this, what policies have been applied to this user only, so I can check and I can edit it. Just click edit and I can change my policy. Okay, right from here, this is the meeting policy, it's a live event policy, app permission policy, call park, app setup, anything. Okay, policy packages, it's recently announced Microsoft Teams settings. It's actually a predefined policy packages by Microsoft. Like if you are in your if your organization is an education organization, then you can apply any education kind of policy packages. Or if you're in your healthcare organization, then healthcare clinical worker organization policy. just SMB business policy. So these are the source policy packages which Microsoft has predefined for you. It has predefined their definition, predefined settings. Meetings. So in the meetings policy, like I said, Teams is all about meetings. Teams is all about having conference calls with your teams, with your members, anyone, or even your clients outside your teams. So meeting policies would play an important role, how this meeting will be governed and how the meetings will be used by the users. So I have these policies created by default by Microsoft. Global organization-wide default, all on, all off, restricted anonymous access. So let's check all on first. What is it? So in the all on policy, we have what we have is, okay, I think this has been deprecated by Microsoft by itself. Okay, anyways, I just came to know this. So let's move to any other. This has also been deprecated. Okay. Let's go to the first one. Okay. So this is the global policy which have been applied to almost every user. So what it says is allow meet now in channels. So this is the meet now button which you see here. Let me go to Teams. I'm not sure where it went, but there must be there would be a button here called Meet Now. Okay, so that would be used for meeting, setting your meeting right away. Okay, so I'm not sure why it is not appearing for me. Anyways, so this is a button where in the channel you will see a Meet Now button here, right in the top bar, right top. Okay. So allow the Outlook add-in. So Outlook has its add-in for Teams, so you can install it. Allow channel meeting scheduling. Allow scheduling private meetings, like the one-on-one meetings which you can schedule, like here. Oops. In the calendar, you can see the Meet Now button in the calendar, but this type of button will be appearing here in Teams channels. So this is a meeting that you can create one-on-one with your members or channels or anyone. Okay. Audio and video settings. Allow transcriptions. Transcriptions are currently off because not all languages have been applicable for transcribed. Okay. So this have been off. Allow cloud recordings. Like I said in my Teams part 1 and part 2 video, your video calls can be recorded and can be uploaded to Microsoft Teams, but this must be on first. This setting must be on, then you will be able to record your videos. Mode for IP audio, outgoing, incoming audio enabled. So both outgoing and incoming audio are enabled. Same for videos. And media bitrate, it's 50,000 KBs set. So these are the audio settings for your audio devices. Content sharing, screen sharing mode, you can see, you can share your entire screen, a single application, or you can disable it. So no one would be able to share the screen. Allow participant to give request control. Yes, what you can do is when you are in the call, so your participant can request that to give him a control of your system. It's used by for help desk system. If you have your help desk team, so they can request controls to their client, to their customers, to resolve or troubleshoot any issue. External has been off because the external cannot be able to use. So if on it, so any external team members like Hotmail or Live account or any other organization accounts will be able to give access or give control. Allow PowerPoint sharing, any PPT that you want to share. Allow whiteboard, allow shared notes, the shared notes meet notes that I showed you in the part 2 of the video. Let anonymous people start a meeting. Anonymous people mean like if there are any external ones or anyone that that you haven't been authenticated or haven't allowed in the meeting, are they allowed to start a meeting? They should be off because it's a risk for organizations. So I have turned it off. Automatically admit people. You have select everyone in your organization. So everyone in your organization only will be automatically admitted to a meeting. But otherwise, everyone shall have to go into lobby first. Okay, then they will be admitted. Allow dial-in users to bypass the lobby off. So those users which are joining the meeting using the dial-in, dial pad or phone. Allow meet non-private meetings. I have turned it on. Enable live captions, disabled. Okay, allow chat in meetings. Yes, I have enabled, so you can chat with your team as along with the video call. So let's save the settings. Let's go to the next meeting settings. So this is the same settings. If they can join the meeting, yes, they can join the meeting, but they cannot start the meeting. Okay, join means that someone has asked them to join. Okay. Start the meeting means that no one has asked them to join, but they have started the meeting. Okay, so this can be done. Anonymous can join. So in meeting settings, you can set your organization email invitation as a for the compliance or governance purposes. It should be a unified. So we can just paste a logo URL, a legal URL, a help URL or footer, so that your members or your participant would see a set of particular meeting invite. Okay, same goes to the settings of network. Okay, how you send how you handle your team, the quality of service I will show you later on. This is the video quality, call quality of services for the teams. Port ranges, these are the port ranges. Okay, total 20 ports for audio, video and screen sharing are allowed. Okay, live event policy. This is a very interesting thing. This is a same like a webinar. So you can host a webinar in your teams right away. Like if you go here, if you click here, see live event. But this will only be able to work if you have Exchange Online license. Okay. And if you are in a hybrid environment, you have to be, your identity have to be migrated and your mailbox have to be migrated as well with Exchange Online license. So then you can use live event. Okay. So live event policy, also global policy is applied here. Auto scheduling is on, transcription for attendees. Like I said, transcription is not labeled for all languages. Only certain languages are allowed. So I have turned it off. Who can join live events? Everyone in your organization who can record, always record. Okay, so these are the some settings for live event policies. This is a support URL that will be appearing for participant during the live event if they have any trouble joining it. So this is the support URL. You can change your own, you can write your own, simple. Third party distribution providers, any third party application that you want to involve in your live event, you can just check it here. Okay. So I think we have covered most of the thing. I will be back in another video because this is a long video for Teams Admin Center. I will be making a part 2 of Teams Admin Center to discuss all the remaining features. Okay, so let's stop here and wait for me in the second video. I will be making it very shortly and upload on my YouTube channel. So please watch my videos, the part 1 and part 2 for Teams overview, and I hope you like it. Thank you so much for joining.